Hi, I am Pawan. I'll be teaching you science. Today I'll be teaching you about 6th standard first lesson, our food, lecture 3. Lecture 1 and 2 are completed. Lecture 1 and 2, what we have discussed, you just recollect. You just pause the video and just recollect them. Yeah. Now let me write the points that we have discussed in the previous class. In the previous class we talked about variety of food and ingredients used in the foods and sources of ingredients. And also we talked about dry fruits and condiments. We have talked about these topics in the previous class. Okay, children. Now, at the end of previous class, I gave you a project work, right? What was the project work? The project work is to find the name of plant and part of the plant we eat. Okay. This was the project work given for you in the at the end of the last class. Have you got it? Here, I hope you have done that. If you have done, that's well and good. And I wanted to give you the full information about this table that which is displayed on the screen, and this is as a project work. You just compare your answers with these answers and you see that. Okay, children, what was the project work given? Name of plant and part of the plant we eat. Okay. Yeah. See, children, you just carefully observe the table displayed on the screen, and I talk about the table, you two follow me. Yeah. First, name of the plant, fenugreek. Fenugreek is a plant. In our local language, we call this plant as mentulu. And which part of this plant do we eat? We eat leaves and seeds. Okay, leaves and seeds. And next plant, mustard plant. Which part of mustard plant do we eat? And what do we call this mustard plant in our local language? Mustard plant in our local language is avalu. Which part of this plant do we eat? We eat seeds. You might have seen your mother cooking curry, and before your mother starts cooking, you know, to fry some ingredients in oil, avalu or mustard seeds are used. You know, you observe, you ask your mother, the black and the small size seeds are used as food ingredients, they are mustard seeds. And then sugar cane, which part of this plant do we eat? Sugar cane. Which part of the sugar cane do we eat? Stem. Stem, right? Carrot. Let us talk about carrot. Yeah? Which part of the carrot? Where does it grow? Does it grow above the ground or under the ground? Carrot grows where? Under the ground. The diagram I draw on that board. Can you see? Which part of the plant present under the ground usually? Root, right? Yes, but is it looking like a root? No, right? It's looking like a cone, right? It's looking like a cone. Here, this part of the carrot is called as modified root. Which part of the carrot do we eat? Which part of the carrot do we eat? We eat root, or it's not like normal root, like, you know, tap root, fibrous root, like that. It's a modified root. The food is stored in carrot after the roots modified. Okay. Now, another plant. Let us talk about another plant. Yeah. Where does onion grow? Onion also grows under the ground. And if you look at the board carefully, yeah. What is this? Name of this part is leaves, and name of this part is roots. Okay, and what about this? A part is missing from the plant, that is stem, right? But is it looking like a stem? No. So we can call this as modified stem. Modified in the sense changed stem. Okay. Then this type of stem is called as bulb. This type of stem is called as bulb. See, children, in onion, which part of the plant do we use as our food? Modified stem. Okay. Now, let us talk about cabbage. Let us talk about what? Cabbage. Which part of the plant do we use as our food? Which part of the plant we use as our food? Which part of the plant do we use as our food? If you see the picture on the screen, you can see only folded leaves. Folded leaves. See, the leaves are folded and they modified, you know, like a folded, they come close. And the leaves are used as our food. Now you can say, which part of that cabbage plant do we use as our food? Leaves. And we can say about this, especially about cabbage, we can take whole plant as our food. Okay, cabbage can be used, you know, cabbage, whole cabbage can be used as whole plant of cabbage can be used as our food, right? Okay, whole plant can be used as our food. Next, other part, another plant. Next, another plant. What? Asafoetida. What is that? Asafoetida. Asafoetida is used as condiment. You know, it's like a condiment. You know, it is dried and it is powdered. And what? Which part? We are going to discuss about which part of it, right? Roots and bark or stems of asafoetida can be used as our food. We make it powder, and the powder is used as our food ingredient. And one thing that you need to know, that what do we call asafoetida in our local language? We call it as ingua. What do we call it? Ingua. Asafoetida, we can call it as ingua. What do we call? Ingua. Yes. Now, yeah, we talked about the project work, right, that you have done, and I have given you the answers. Now let us try to answer some of the questions. Yes, the questions like, you know, the questions like, yeah, first question, which part of the plant, the plant's generally we eat? Yeah, which part of the plant generally we eat? Yes, we have discussed about the project work, right? We eat leaves, stems and roots and some seeds. Yes, here some of the plants modified stem and modified roots are used as our food. Okay, next, another question for you. Name of the plant which gives flower as our food. What is that question? Name of the plant which gives flower as our food. Yeah, can you name? You just think about the flowers that we use as our food. Yes, a vegetable is there. The meaning in its name, that we can understand. Cauliflower. Yes. What? And also, some of the people use banana as our food. Okay. Next, one more question. Yes, is there any plant of which whole plant can be eaten? Yes, we have talked about this, right? Which part, which plant you know, is there any plant of which whole plant or part? Yes. What is that? Cabbage can be eaten as whole part. Now let us talk about how people develop their food habits. How people develop their food habit. How people develop their food habit? Say two main reasons. In that, one is geographical or climatic conditions, and then cultural practices. Okay, so these are the main reasons for the people developing their food habits. You know, if you talk about geographical and climatic conditions, the people living in different geographical areas, you know, the climate is not same in different geographical areas, right? So due to that changes in the climate and geographical conditions, the people used to grow different types of crops in that areas. Okay, so that because of that, the people develop that food as their regular food. Okay, got it? And in especially in our state, if you talk, our state geographical and climatic conditions suits to grow only paddy. That is why the people in our state, the farmers in our state, grow paddy. Paddy as a staple food, right? So we made that paddy or rice as our regular food habit. Yes, this is how the people developed the food habits. Understood? No. Now, if you talk about the Rajasthan people, in Rajasthan, the people, you know, the geographical and climatic conditions in Rajasthan, you know, that suits to grow maize, bajra, and wheat. Because of that, the people cultivate those crops and they made that, you know, they made roti or chapati as their regular food. Okay, this is how the people developed their food habits. Let us talk about the methods of preparing the foods. You know, I want you to do a project, I want you to do an activity by asking your parents, and you just name some methods that your parents or your mother follows to cook different types of food items. Yes, you just name, you ask your mother to say the names of the methods followed to cook that kind of food item. For example, I tell you, eggs, we boil it. It's a method of preparation. Boiling is a method of preparation. Okay, rice, boiling. Okay, and you know, some cooks, you know, that, you know, for example, if you take chicken, it is fried, and it is roasted, and it is, you know, different. These are the methods you have to understand. Yes, and you know, other types of methods. You just collect the information about the methods that we follow to prepare different types of food items, and be prepared for the next class, and we'll be discussing about all of these methods. And a single food can be prepared using different methods. That will also be discussed in the next class. I hope you understood all this, and thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.